My burger is here. I requested for the burger to be split into two. It's a bit of a mess, but a tasty mess. I think most people in this part of the world like the pasta to have a bit more sauce, and that certainly is the sort of pasta that this is.
We were open from October, but I could see that graph high in the month of November and December, actually. Okay. In the Jan month also fine. It was good customers walking was there. Later after the COVID issues, we went down.
You went down completely?
Actually, yes.
Hi folks, it's a pleasant evening here in Namma Bengaluru, and I've just stepped out of the office. Well, we're in between Christmas and New Year's Eve, and perhaps by the time this vlog is released, it may be closer to New Year's Eve, or we may be well into 2021. We are in the traditional holiday season, so I see signs of festivity, though much muted here and there. And of course, we all look forward to 2021. In the hope, in the anticipation that things will be a lot better than the year that's just about to close. 2020 has been a rough year for most, and it's been especially tough for small businesses. Many that perhaps will not see the new year. And this evening I've set out to visit a tiny neighborhood cafe that is tottering on the brink of closure. So let's see what this cafe is all about, and if there is anything that collectively us and all of you watching out here can do to help this small business. This is the Elephant Bowl Resto Cafe. Burger, steak, pizza. This looks like a really tiny cafe. I really don't know what to expect. I've just stepped out just in the hope that we can perhaps help somebody. So let's see what happens. Hi.
Yes, sir.
You're Sushma.
Yes, sir.
You're the one who reached out to me.
Yes, sir.
So this is your cafe.
Yes, sir.
Hi.
Yeah, and that's my friend.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. It's a very cozy, quaint sort of a cafe. So how did you start this?
It was an interest for us. During college days, we used to sit and we used to say, like, we needed to do something. So after quite a few years, after passing out college, we friends decided, okay, we'll do this.
Do a cafe.
Yes, sir. My friend, actually, she's not here now. Her name is Chaitanya.
Chaitanya.
Yeah.
So Sushma, you and Chaitanya are partners.
Yes, sir.
So you had this dream of setting up a cafe.
And why it had this one? Because as I know there were a lot of biryani shops and all in this locality, actually.
So you want to do something different. And that's how you hit upon a cafe. And when was this? When did you start?
It was in October last year.
October 2019?
Yes, sir.
When you began this?
Yes, sir.
And you were telling me that when you began, you had some issues initially.
Issues, yes. We had a lot of issues, actually.
What happened?
We wanted to take a franchisee from a guy. So initially, he told he'll help us regarding the setting up the cafe and everything.
Huh.
We paid him initially some advance and about a 5 lakhs. Yes, sir.
Okay.
So later, when we tried to reach him, he was not answering our calls or something.
You lost that money.
Yes, actually.
And then you had the space already at that point?
At that point, yes.
So you didn't know what to do with it?
Yeah. Later we... my other friend, he helped me meet the another guy called as Javed. So he helped us setting the entire cafe last year.
And that's how you began. And when did you finally begin operations? October 2019.
October itself, yes.
And how was it going then?
It was picking up.
Mm-hmm.
In the month of again Feb to March, there was a COVID issue, and again we went down actually.
So who are your customers who come here?
Mainly the IT people, students for birthday celebration, they'll reach out us.
Okay.
Some family gatherings are also here.
And how is business now?
Now it's picking up.
Okay. But the place is empty at this point.
Yeah.
Why is that?
I'm not sure, but usually during the weekends, there'll be some people here,
okay.
But from Monday, Tuesdays and Wednesday, this will be empty. Like this.
So are you struggling with the business at this point in time?
Struggling? Yes.
Okay, and what's the way forward?
We have to see to that actually.
Yeah.
So that's the reason we reaching out to you. Maybe this could help us.
You reached out and you were very persistent, I must say. I think you reached out to me on Instagram, on Facebook, even on LinkedIn.
I had emailed you.
You mailed me thrice.
Yes.
And I think, or the four times, I don't remember. I think one of your emails you said that you were very disappointed
that you didn't get back.
And that you would close if you didn't get back.
It would be difficult.
And that's the reason why we're here. So I said, let me at least come here and say hello to Sushma and see what she's doing.
Thank you so much, sir.
So what's the concept here? I mean, what is the... It's quite a colorful looking place.
Actually, it's a kind of love towards elephants.
Love towards elephants?
Yes.
So you like elephants. That's my Elephant Bowl Cafe.
Yes, actually.
So is that your mascot? And what's the kind of food that you do?
Italian and continental.
Italian continental. And who does the food?
Chef, sir.
Oh, okay. Can I take a peek in your
sure,
kitchen?
Sure, sir, sure.
Hi, guys.
Hi, sir.
How are you?
Fine, sir. Fine.
What is special? What's cooking?
Currently nothing, sir.
Currently nothing is cooking. But when things were cooking, what were you cooking?
We cook like pizza, pasta, and burgers.
So this is your cozy kitchen for your cozy cafe.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, guys. I'll order some food. Yeah. How many customers did you have today?
Today? No. I think we had few Zomato and Swiggy orders. That's it. No walk-ins.
No walk-ins. So because the kitchen is looking like it's not been used today.
No, it's cleaned up actually.
It's cleaned up.
Yeah.
Because I was coming.
Huh? No, it'll be this way.
Yeah. You sure?
Yes, yeah. Very much sure.
Is it like this always?
Yes, sir.
Okay. These are your desserts. You have your blueberry cheesecake.
Yes.
So you're a friend.
I'm a friend.
So you're not involved in the running of the cafe.
So I really come here to work, right?
You come here to work.
Yeah. So now we have working from home, right? So whenever I'm free, I'll just drop.
What's your name?
Dakshaini.
Yeah, I think I also
reached out to you.
You also reached out to me.
Couple of times.
And I think you people would.
I got a reply from you.
Yeah.
To connect with. And then I
picked up. And I think even on various posts of us, you would put something.
Yeah, I used to.
Yes, we did that actually.
I used to.
Alright, the food has to do the talking. So, do you have a menu? Can I sit down?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Oh, so you have multiple menus. You have a very big menu for a small cafe.
Yes, sir.
Huh? So, I'm going to try like 4 or 5 things. So, what do you want me to try? I'm going to leave it entirely to you today. Is there any appetizers that your guests like? What are the appetizers that they order?
They do order the barbecue chicken, buffalo wings.
The wings, okay.
Yes, and the roast chicken, yes.
How are your soups?
You have to try one, actually. Yeah? Yeah.
What is a good vegetarian soup?
The vegetable, the clear soup.
Which is a clear soup here? Because I see cream of soup, I see manchow, I see...
Actually, our chefs, they do customize for her some other soups also, apart from...
So, give me a clear vegetable soup. Who's going to cook? What's your name?
Praveen.
Where were you working before this?
The smokehouse.
You're working with smokehouse?
Yes.
With Chef Saurabh?
Yes.
And how long have you been here?
It's been like 5 months.
5 months. Alright, fine. So give me a soup. So what is the plan to get more customers here?
We are actually reaching out them through all the social medias and we are also distributing flyers. So whatever possible by hand, we are actually trying our best.
Before COVID, how were things then? Were you...
Before COVID, okay, I felt like it was picking up gradually.
Picking up.
Yeah, actually, like in the beginning days, we were open from October, but I could see that graph high in the month of November and December actually.
Okay.
In the Jan month also fine. It was... good customers walk-in was there. Later after the COVID issues, we went down.
You went down completely?
Actually, yes.
This is on rent?
Yes, this is
so right. Do you pay rent?
Yes, sir.
Is it difficult to make rent happen?
Yes, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How are you able to manage salaries, rent?
Somehow balancing now, but I'm not sure like how long I could continue doing this.
So you're putting money?
From my hand, yes, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, they're all helping.
So all of you are putting in money to keep this afloat?
Yeah.
Because we have to run this. So all are helping me in that. After getting married, that time it triggered me like doing something rather than sitting idle at home. So after that 1 year, I was, you know, like I had no idea what to do because I was newly married. So I took a year time. So later, my in-laws, my husband, they actually supported me. Fine, I had to do something, so.
This pizza, we had the bigger one and the burgers as well. And then they launched the Chicka Pizza and then Chota Burger.
Chicka Pizza.
Yeah.
I like that. Chicka Pizza.
Chicka Pizza.
Namma Bangalore Chicka Pizza sikkate illi. Are you from Bangalore?
Both yes,
mother tongue is Kannada?
Yes,
sir. So what do you want to have, Nathan? You want coffee, you want chocolate, you want strawberry?
Butterscotch.
I ask you anything, then I give you three choices, and you select the fourth
butterscotch.
One.
Butterscotch.
Butterscotch milkshake for Nathan. Veg clear soup. Well, my soup is here, so time to get the show on the road. And we are somewhere in HBR layout in East Bengaluru. So this is also the time that I'm actually breaking my fast, my intermittent fast. It's been a 21-hour fast. So I thought we should break the fast with something vegetarian. So therefore, I have this lovely looking, at least, clear soup. I can see the soup is loaded with veggies. Well, that's a wholesome vegetable soup. So you've got tiny dices of some zucchini, some broccoli. I think there's some capsicum, perhaps some carrot as well. And tons of garlic. Is the same soup that you had?
Yeah, I had the same soup.
You had the same soup. So it turns out Dasheni had the exact same soup before I walked into the cafe. There's plenty of garlic. So perhaps if you don't want too much garlic, you can ask the chef to go a little easy on the garlic. But it's a satisfying soup. It's a sort of soup that you probably break a fast with. And that's exactly what I'm doing on a slightly nippy Bengaluru evening. I think a soup like this is a good start to an early supper for a double hit of the garlic on the toast and also the garlic from the soup. Well, after beginning on a light note with the vegetable soup that I am still not done with, we have a couple of indulgent plates. So that is the barbecue chicken wing and then the butter garlic prawn. I think we're going to begin with the butter garlic prawns. Personally, I would have liked a little more punch in the butter garlic sauce. I think the batter in this prawn seems to somehow overpower the prawn. Let's get some of the veggies. You have some peppers here, red, yellow, and green. I think there's some onion there as well. I think if the sauce had a little more punch of the garlic and perhaps was slightly less stodgier, this certainly would be an interesting dish. But then you have the crunch of the vegetables and the peppers. I think let's go next for that barbecue chicken wings. Plenty of barbecue sauce that's slathered over this wing, and the chicken seems to have benefited from a period of rest in the barbecue sauce, perhaps some ginger garlic, etc. And that chicken wing is seasoned all the way in. You have that earthy sweetness of that barbecue sauce and you have a bit of that chili. I think I'm going to go for another one of those drumsticks. You have that delicate crunch of the batter and then you have the flavor of that barbecue sauce. I can also detect some rosemary on my palate. So perhaps when they marinate the chicken, along with the barbecue sauce, the ginger garlic and the chili paste, there's also some herbs and I can definitely detect the rosemary in that. When you're eating wings, make sure you have plenty of paper napkins on the side because that's what you need as you go through those wings. This is the barbecue chicken pizza and the pesto pizza. Well, our table is running out of space to keep the condiments, the pizza. Of course, we have the butter garlic prawns and the wings also. This is the
All-American Chicken Burger.
The All-American Chicken Burger. Well, I now have the pizza. This is a 11-inch pizza, I think. But they also have the option of a smaller pizza. I think they call it the
Chicka Pizza.
The Chicka Pizza. The tiny pizza in Kannada. And this one is with a vegetable in a pesto sort of a sauce. And then we have a barbecue chicken right here. And what we have here is a burger. This is what they call the all-American burger, and this certainly seems to be a loaded burger. So this is a smaller burger, but this is certainly a burger that I will struggle to get all the layers in one bite. So this is a multiple layered burger. So I've got a cheese patty on top. I've got some more bread here, which I think is going to be a challenge. We've got a chicken patty, a chicken mince patty, some egg. And there's also some bacon, but this I'm told is chicken bacon. But I think I'm going to request chef, can you cut this into half for me? Yeah. So I think while he's doing that, we'll take a look at the pizza. And I think I'm going to make a beginning with the pizza with vegetables and pesto. Well, this pizza has the vegetables, of course, but then there's also the pineapple, and that pineapple is a ripe pineapple that brings in its sweetness. You also have some paneer, so you've got the softness of the paneer, and then you have the crunch of the peppers, and then you have the sweet bite of the pineapple. My burger is here. I requested for the burger to be split into two. It's a bit of a mess, but a tasty mess. I think that burger bun is unable to contain all the fillings within that burger. I like the textures that one is biting through. So you first have that crunch of a patty. This is a patty that has some cheese in it, some onions, etc. Also some herbs that I can see. And then you have a thick slice of bread again, followed by the chicken mince patty and some eggs. What I also like is the spicing in that burger patty. So there's a bit of chili that I'm tasting in that burger patty. So that chili helps cut through the creaminess of the cheese. So there's a cheddar patty right on top, and then you have that burger patty. So there's a bit of spice that comes through, and that cheese patty is crumbed. So you have that texture, that crunch as you bite into that crumb. I think that's attempt to bring our burger back together. Bring the egg, bring some of that chicken, the remnants of that chicken patty, a tiny dice of tomato, and hopefully get all the flavors of that burger packed into one bite. I think that burger was certainly an enjoyable one, barring the fact that there is too much filling for that delicate burger bun to hold within itself. I'm tempted to go for that second half of that burger, especially with all those layers of that cheddar cheese that's oozing its way out of that burger, flecked with some of the herbs, some chili flakes, some onions as well. And then of course you have another slice of cheese there, some eggs, and that chicken patty. On that note, let's move on to that pizza. This is the thin crust barbecue chicken pizza. I think the chicken fare is slightly better than the vegetarian, because I think the chicken has some structure that is still able to balance itself against the breadiness of that pizza crust. Let's taste a bit of the pasta. I don't want to waste the whole pasta, and that's why I'm going to just help myself in a side plate here. So you have some penne. I think those are jalapenos there. It's a Mexican sauce, so I suppose it's a tomato sauce that's been spiced up with chilies, with jalapenos. There's also a bit of corn that I see here, shavings of cheese, perhaps the Parmesan or perhaps the Grana Padano. And then of course you have the customary basil, the Italian basil leaf. That sauce certainly is a sort that seizes hold of your taste buds with this chili spike. I think most people in this part of the world like the pasta to have a bit more sauce. And that certainly is the sort of pasta that this is. The pasta has integrated itself into the sauce. It's not classical al dente, where you want the pasta to have a bit of a bite. But if you like your pasta saucy, with some veggies, and with that spicy zing, this is a pasta that you will enjoy. So it really depends on what sort of a pasta you're looking for. Also, at the end of the day, you're dining in a neighborhood cafe. You're not really looking to do fine dining when you are entering a space like this. You're basically looking at a place where you can just chill, grab a bite, maybe chit-chat with a friend, and eat some tasty food along the way. And for that, this penne in a spicy arrabbiata sauce does the job. What is this?
Blueberry cheesecake.
Mm. Now that's a cheesecake that makes you want to go for the second spoon. You know, when it comes to dessert, refusing the first spoon is the easiest because you haven't tasted it yet. But refusing the second spoon or the third spoon becomes difficult, especially if you've enjoyed the first. And that certainly seems to be the case here. So there's a bit of the blueberry jelly or the blackcurrant jelly, the compote that you have on top. But what I like is the consistency of the cream cheese. That cream cheese is smooth. It's a sort that you place in your mouth and enjoy its delicate sweetness and flavors while it slowly disappears into a moist pool of slightly sweet, slightly tart deliciousness.
How did you like the food, sir?
I'm enjoying this cheesecake, the blueberry cheesecake.
Cheesecake, yes.
Is this your popular cheesecake?
Yes, sir.
I like that. I like the sweetness, but I also like the fact that the sweetness is offset by some of that tartness. It's just a sort that cuts off all flavors of all the dishes that you may have had earlier. So for instance, that vegetable soup that was loaded with garlic, the barbecue sauce, chicken wings, and then of course the last dish that I tasted was the pasta with that spicy Mexican sauce. So this cheesecake is taking all those flavors away. And all that's going to remain as I drive back, I think, is the flavor of this cheesecake. So I enjoyed this cheesecake very much. I enjoyed the barbecue wings were nice. But of course, you know, when we were shooting, so that barbecue wing also got a little cold. But despite that, I still enjoyed it. And I think that burger is something that I would return for. Only request that I would make to the chef when I come next time is to reduce that one slice of bread in between.
In between, yes.
So then I'm tasting more of the stuffing. I'm tasting more of the filling. I'm tasting more of the cheese patty. I'm tasting more of the chicken, the egg, right? You always like to taste more of the filling.
Fillings. Exactly.
That's what I would probably do. The pasta was enjoyable. I think, you know, for somebody, if somebody likes it very saucy, I think that's something that you would want to do. I think the pizza, I feel that sometimes when you put a pizza in an oven, you want to make sure that the pizza oven is really hot. If the pizza oven is not hot, and when you put a pizza in, the moisture from the stuffing seeps through the pizza base and it makes it doughy.
Yeah.
And I think that's what probably happened. I think places like these are more about places where you chill out, right?
Yes.
Is that what your customers come to do?
Yes, sir. They usually take the space for working here.
Huh. Oh, they come here and work through
yes.
the day.
Even she comes here to work.
Oh, you? Oh, is that what you were doing as well?
Yeah, yeah. Yes. I was working here.
So because she was working, you put her to work. Saying if you're working on your own work, you do my work too. So that's what people do. So they kind of come here and they just kind of chill and they order some food by the side and things like that. Yeah, I think that's what places like these are about. I think these are places that over a period of time become a part of the neighborhood, right? So these are places that people around would probably walk in, maybe to have a cheesecake or maybe to just have that burger. I'm happy you have some customers now.
Yes, sir.
All that I can do is wish you the very best.
Thank you, sir.
We are really glad to have you here.
I'm happy that I made it here. Bit of a trek, but I think there are some dishes, if I'm in the area, I will certainly drop in to taste, like this cheesecake right here.
Please do.
The burger and perhaps that chicken wings too. Wish you the very best.
Thank you so much, sir.
Well, when we stepped in here, there were no customers, but at least now they have two or three customers sitting in there. It's quite tough to watch establishments like these, where a group of friends, in this case three girls, who were passionate about starting a cafe. It was a dream for them from college. Much later in life, they got together, pooled in some money to begin this cafe. And even when they began the cafe, it wasn't without its challenges. In the first instance, they got cheated by someone where they lost most of the capital, but then they had the space and only an empty promise from the person to help them build this cafe. Left with no recourse, the girls had no choice but to somehow get this cafe going, and that's what happened with the Elephant Bowl Cafe. And then, of course, as we know, COVID struck and their world came crashing down. Well, the food at this cafe is typically what you would expect to find in a cafe. When you go into a cafe, you know you're going to get some interesting food, but it's not the sort of food that you will expect in a dining destination. After all, this is a place that you hang out in, this is a place that you chill out in, and for that, the food that they serve more than does its job. All that I could do sitting in there was encourage the girls, offer them some advice, and I hope those of you who are in this area of East Bengaluru, HBR layout, will also find some time to come in and encourage. I think neighborhood eateries like these need our support, need some encouragement. I hope you will find the time and the heart to support a neighborhood enterprise like this. I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.